Good evening, class. It is Professor Kensington, of course, and tonight I am joining you via satellite from our excavation site in Colorado. Now, tonight is going to be a very special class. As some of you might have heard, my team and I have uncovered what we believe to be a complete and very well-preserved Tyrannosaurus Minimus specimen. So I have that with me right now, and we will begin excavation soon. Now, I know, I can hear some of you laughing in the background, and I don't blame you. It was thought previously that the Tyrannosaurus Minimus was nothing but a myth, but recently we have been uncovering some fossil evidence that suggests otherwise. But up until this point, we haven't discovered anything to completely change our previous theories. But tonight, we just might be able to do that. And if that is the case, as you know, all of us, but especially me, will be making a paleontological history. And that is very exciting. So, I know we're all eager to begin. So, why don't we go ahead and get to the excavation? Alright, so, as you can see, I have my specimen here, along with all of the tools I will need to complete the excavation. And you will also notice that the specimen is still in its field wrapping. And we do seal every fossil that we find in the field, just to ensure that it is not damaged in transport to the lab. And you will also notice that the safety information is detailed in many languages to ensure proper care of the specimen. So, safety first. And, of course, you do want to keep this plastic wrapper away from babies and children, as it states. That is also a good rule for paleontological finds and fossils in general. So, why don't we get started? I will begin by breaking the seal. And seeing what we have here. Begin soon. As you can see, I have my large soft brush here. A very important tool. I also have a stiffer plastic brush. This is good for getting all of the sandstone out of the nooks and crannies in the fossils. I have my hammer. And of course, a screwdriver with a flathead bit, very important. Some people like to use a chisel. But I find that this works just as well. So let's get started here. Okay. We're starting to make good progress. discovered something very close to the surface. As you know, it's important to clear the dust away periodically. Oh, this is very exciting. I do see something emerging here. Let me see if I can get a close-up for all of you. Going to be very, very exciting. As you know by now, paleontology does require a lot of patience. But it does have such great rewards. There's definitely something here. We want to take care when we do find that the chisel is not moving as easily through the sandstone. Because, of course, we could be damaging the fossil that we are working so hard to preserve. And that would be a tragedy. Oh, this is so exciting. It is too bad that you could not be here with me. I hope you are still benefiting from the lesson via satellite. As you know, the school does have limited resources at the moment, and so we could not bring everybody. That is just how it is sometimes. If you were not able to come for this excavation, I'm sure we'll be able to find a spot for you on our next outing. clear away some of the debris. So right here, we do see the fossil beginning to emerge. We need only be persistent and careful in order to ensure the safe excision. You can see we are generating quite a bit of dust. Let's use the big brush again. And just sweep some of that away. There we go. Now my team and I have determined, using the most sophisticated subterranean imaging technology available to us, that we do have in this slab a complete skeleton. Now, of course, that is not enough to say with certainty that the Tyrannosaurus Minimalis exists. But we are very excited to see what we do have here. As you can see, we now know that it is something significant. Although, what it is for certain, we just can't say. Not at this time. I know that it's hard to believe now, but there were those who laughed at me and mocked me for believing that a miniature Tyrannosaurus could exist. But as you will soon see, I will be the one having the last laugh. Okay. Now, this is quite challenging work, and at times it might be a bit tedious, so I do suggest that, if at all possible, you find a group of assistants, or, in my case, naive students, are willing to do most of the work, but for this discovery, I wanted to be sure that I was the one that unearthed it myself. Something like this just doesn't happen every day. It isn't as though you can just go out to the Smithsonian and buy a fossil excavation kit with a previously unknown dinosaur species hidden inside. That just isn't how it works. I'm not quite sure what we're looking at here just yet. Alright, let's see. We can clear a bit more of this dust away. And then we may begin to use a bit of water to soften the stone for us and make the extraction process a bit easier. All we need is a small pipette. Can see. And that's going to soften that area right up. And the other thing that it does, as you can see, is make the fossil itself more prominent. So we can get a really good idea of what we're looking at. Again, gently brush away the remaining, the surrounding debris. And you can see right in here. And here, the bone is still lodged firmly in the sandstone, so we must continue to work the surrounding area in order to free it. And we turn the fossil so that you can get another view of it here. And there. You can understand we're dealing with. us continue. Particular fossil continues up here, but I have reached. Ah, yes. Yes, I suppose that it does. And this fossil is actually much larger than I had anticipated. Yes, indeed. So let's get a look at this here. This is quite fascinating. It looks like we are beginning to uncover the rib cage. Let me reorient this so that you may see. Yes, this fossil is much larger than I anticipated. But that is all right. We will still extract it with as much care as possible. Yes, let me again move the specimen so you can get a better view. That is most definitely a rib cage we are dealing with. looks like... looks like we may be uncovering... a forelimb. Let's use a bit more water. Very good. As I said, when it comes to this kind of work, you just have to be patient. But your patience will be rewarded. Some of the dust. As you can see, we're making quite a bit of progress. We may even be on the way to resuming our first fragment. brush. This is looking very nice indeed. But then again, as you may know, I always do the most excellent work. And the bones do seem to be packed in here, one on top of the other, which is very strange. I'm not quite sure yet why that is. Let me move the specimen here so that you can see what we're working on. We will need some more water. look like we are now able, or are almost able, to extract the first piece. Thing is not quite right. It is snagged on something. Put a little water out to soften it right up. Looks like we have recovered our first fossil. Let me move this out of the way. This is quite extraordinary, as I suspected. It is indeed a fossilized remnant of the Tyrannosaurus Minimus. This is quite an incredible discovery. Just look at that. That is a beautifully preserved fossil. Unlike anything we have ever seen. Just truly stunning. So let's get back to work. Of course, there is still much work for us to do. If I'm not mistaken, I found a foot here. Let's see if we can't extract that. hopefully we will be able to remove the portion of this foot shortly. Yes. I can see it now. It appears to be hidden from your view at the time being. Right here. There's a ridge blocking your view. Let's see if we can't extract this foot. No. Unfortunately, that does not appear possible at the moment. Buried too deeply. Okay, let's resume our digging. You may be close to the skull. Now we will need a brush. Not quite sure what we've found yet. That was interesting. Okay. It does appear as though we've found a skull. This is fascinating. Just absolutely fascinating. This right here is proof. Tyrannosaurus Minimus. And we are the first to ever see it. Of course, this will go back to the lab to be professionally cleaned. There's no harm in seeing how much of the dirt we can remove here. Truly, truly. So we found a skull, and a rib cage and part of a pelvis. See if we can now remove the leg. We see now a good portion of the leg remains in the sandstone. So as you know, we will just have to dig a bit deeper. Okay, so here it looks like we have found the final lick. This should be fairly simple to extract now. We're making quite a lot of progress. In a short amount of time here. I do think we'll be able to finish in our regular class time. Now we're beginning work on freeing the tail. sandstone. Tail clean. So far, we've recovered about half of the skeleton. And the other half should not be long coming. I'm quite excited to recover the rest of it and to begin the work of restoring it. And then, of course, presenting it to the rest of the scientific community. I can tell you right now, they will not know what to make of this. This may be the most important discovery of the 21st century. Okay, let's brush this off. I think what we have here is actually the tail. What we found before might have been the spine. Let's get some water on here. Very good. Okay. Yes, that is most certainly tail. Isn't that looking beautiful? Let's get some more water over here. There we go. And blue brush. I know this is making some relaxing sounds, but I want you to do your best to not fall asleep. I do not react well when people fall asleep in my class. I will tell you that right now. And I also don't know how you could possibly sleep when we are so close to finishing our excavation and making history together. This is quite exciting. Once again, need some more water. Brush away the debris. I know you must be getting excited, as I am. see the very end of the tail now, quite easily. I'm going to use a wet brush to clear away some of the dirt. And resume our digging. Tail has been successfully removed. Alright. So one of the parts that we are missing is the other pelvis and ribcage. And we can see that right here. Yes. That is wonderfully clear. Excellent. Let's begin. Okay. So here we see the final piece. Dirt is coming off of that quite nicely. Okay. As you can see here, we have found the last piece of our fossil. And it should be fairly simple to remove. So let's start that. here we are. And we'll just get this cleaned up real quick. And we'll have this sent off to the lab to be cleaned. Alright, so as you can see, we have our cleaned and excavated skeleton here. And now all we must do is assemble it. So here we have the skull. This should just slide in like that. There's all the evidence for this creature's existence that you need. That right there. Okay, let's see. Now we'll attach the femurs to the hips. And on the other side as well. And now I'll attach the skull to the spine. And the spine to the tail. And there you have it. A completed Tyrannosaurus Miniaturalis skeleton. Alright, so here we have it. Our completed Tyrannosaurus Miniaturalis skeleton. And I cannot believe that we were able to find one so well preserved. It's truly amazing. And as I mentioned, if you look closely, you do see that the bones have taken on a plastic sort of quality. And I don't know the mechanism by which this plasticization occurred, but I will send a sample over to our biological chemistry department as soon as possible. And we have plenty of brilliant people working in that department, so I'm sure they will find a satisfactory answer very soon. So, there you are. Thank you all so much for joining me tonight. I'm sorry that none of you will be receiving any credit for this discovery, but you know, that is the way it goes, unfortunately. And maybe someday in the future you will make your own brilliant discoveries, but for today this one is all mine. So thank thank you for joining me, and I am looking forward to seeing you next week.